of Business Administration or BBA is one of the most popular course opted by students immediately after 12th standard. The BBA course is the gateway to a great number of opportunities in various sectors. So let's discuss about the BBA program offered by Bengaluru City University. There are certain details which every newcomer to this course need to know. First and foremost, BBA is a three-year professional undergraduate course in business management. It is open to all streams of students. That is, students from science, arts, and commerce can get enrolled with BBA program. The BBA program offers knowledge and training in both management and leadership skills, which enables the students to prepare for their better future. So what are the regulations pertaining to BBA program? The objectives of this program is to prepare students to pursue career in fields such as finance, marketing, human resource, and other related managerial areas. This will also enable students to get equipped to join the sector of small, medium, and micro enterprises. It enables the students to have the concept of developing ethical managers with interdisciplinary knowledge and awareness. It helps an individual to grow as an entrepreneur, a businessman, or a woman. The focus is to develop individuals who are globally ready to face the challenges of business, and they should be enabling themselves to solve the problems relating to any area of business operations. And the focus is also to develop business analysts for companies, capital markets, commodity markets, share market, and so on. To prepare students to take up higher education, they can enroll themselves in data analytics, business scientists, researchers, consultants, and even into teaching profession with core competency and knowledge. So this course will also enable students to prepare for competitive examinations such as UPSC, KPSC, and several other staff selection commission. So there is a wide scope for this course. Duration of the course is spread for 3 years, comprising of 6 semesters. So each year there will be 2 semesters, and every student has to complete these 6 semesters to get the degree awarded as bachelor's degree in business administration. And the medium of instruction will be in English language. What are the parameters and criteria for attendance? According to Bengaluru City University, any candidate who has less than 75% of attendance in aggregate will not be allowed to take up university examination. Hence, minimum attendance required for eligibility to take up examination is 75%. What is the percentage for passing? Candidates who have obtained a minimum of 35% marks in the university examination. Your university examination is for 70 plus 30 is internal assessment marks. So out of 70 marks, which is conducted by university examination, and candidate will be qualifying if he secures 25 marks. And in aggregate, he has to get 40% of the marks. That is including of both internal assessment as well as university examination. Then he or she is considered to be as pass. What are the other classification? And what I just discussed is about 35%. Now, what are the other classification of successful candidates? First class, second class, and last class. Those who obtain 60% and above will be considered to be as first class candidate. And those who obtain 50% and above but less than 60% will be categorized as second class. And below, those who secure 40% and above but less than 50% will be considered as past class. So this is the criteria with relating to examination. And what is the pattern of question paper? As I mentioned, 30 marks will be for internal assessment. Remaining 70 marks, the pattern is according to the university guidelines. There are 3 sections. Question paper is divided as Section A, Section B, and Section C. In Section A, a candidate has to answer 5 questions. Each question carries 2 marks. So the total marks for section A is 10. Section B, 3 questions and each question is for 5 marks. So total marks for section B is 15 marks. Section C, candidate has to answer 3 questions and for each question marks awarded is 15 marks. So totally for section C is 45 marks. So the total aggregate of the marks is 70, including section A, B and C, plus 30 marks, which is internal assessment. Per subject, the max award marks awarded is 100. So first semester subjects, which you'll be studying are, which is divided into part 4. Part 1 is languages. So a student would have selected the language, Kannada or Sanskrit or Urdu or any language which he has studied in 10th and 12th standard. So this again, the marks is for 100s divided as IA marks 30 and university exam is 70. And credits for this paper is 2. If you look at the last column, the credits are given for every subject is 2 except for part 4, which I'll be discussing shortly. And in part 1, you have second language, which is English. Part 2 is optional papers. There are 4 papers: financial accounting, principles of management, corporate administration, and production and operations management. Financial accounting is practical subject. Remaining all 3 are theoretical papers. And the credits are 2. Whereas part 3 is business skill development course, a very interesting and important course, which is industrial visits. The college will be organizing industrial visits, and maybe in the another subsequent video, I will give you complete details about part 3 BSTC, which is for 100 marks. And part 4 is foundation course, followed by CC, that is co-curricular and extracurricular activities. One foundation course, which we will brief you shortly and make you to choose the foundation course, which is for 100 marks. And co-curricular and extracurricular activities, which will be awarded by the department, which is for 50 marks. So these are the subjects which you'll be studying in the first semester. So hope you would have understood the guidelines given by the university. What are the rules and regulations? These are the preliminary or basic information which you have to know when you have chosen the course, Bachelor of Business Administration. Definitely this course will be an interesting journey of learning, provided you put your efforts, interest, and discipline will definitely lead you to success. Hope this session would have helped you in understanding the basic information. Thank you all.